Take out the cocky head and two eye whites. We'll sew the left and right eye whites side by side on rounds 11 to 13 in front of the cocky head, with their back sides facing outward. Turn the fabric. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric and finally cut off excess end. The right one is down. Please sew up the left eye white in the same way. Two eye whites are sewn up. Thread a needle with a piece of black yarn and tie a knot at the end. Use the black yarn to embroider the eyes on the eye whites. You can embroider the eyes according to your own preference. Two eyes are completed. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric and finally cut off excess end. then sewn up the ears. Check the position. We'll sew the ears on round 10 of the head. One ear is sewn up. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric and finally cut off excess end. Please sew up the other ear in the same way, bilateral symmetry. Two ears are sewn up. Thread a needle with a piece of coffee yarn and tie a knot at the end. We'll use coffee yarn to embroider three lines under the eyes. Turn the fabric. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric and finally cut off excess end. The hat is completed. Now sew up the coxcomb. Thread the needle with the yarn tail of the coxcomb. Turn this side of slip stitches to the back. Thread the yarn tail out from the top of the yellow hat. Do the same to the other yarn tail. Turn the fabric. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric and finally cut off excess end. Do the same to the other yarn tail. Please finish this step by yourself. Turn the fabric. The coxcomb is sewn up. Thread the needle with a piece of black yarn and tie a knot at the end. We'll use black yarn to embroider the eyes on round 7 of the head, spacing 2 eyes 5 stitches apart, bilateral symmetry. Turn the fabric. Insert the needle into the knot for fixation. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric. And finally, cut off excess end. The eyes are completed. Thread the needle with a piece of orange yarn and tie a knot at the end. We'll use orange yarn to embroider the mouth between rounds 8 to 9, spanning 1 to 2 stitches. Turn the fabric. Conceal the yarn tail inside the fabric, and finally cut off excess end. The mouth is completed. The cheek head is completed. The cheek gnome and shape gnome are completed.